This is probably the biggest fruit in Africa. A single one can weigh as much as 7 kilograms. It is called Allanblackia, in honor of a Scottish botanist, Allanblack. You will find the tree in places like here in Kribi, in the evergreen rainforest, as well as on the highlands of the western region of Cameroon. It also grows in several African countries, from as far west as Sierra Leone and Ghana to as far east as Tanzania. Probably the most special thing about it is the seeds, which are embedded in the fruit. ]50% of these grains, when dry, are composed of an edible oil. The oil melts at 34 degrees centigrade. Below this temperature, and therefore at room temperature, the oil is solid. This is a very, very important characteristic needed by the food industry. It implies that the oil can be used in food products like margarine and ice cream without much modification.
In Allanblackia world, you have something like 50% or 80% of stearic acid, which is really good. But in palm oil, you have 0.00 stearic acid. So Allanblackia oil, in short, is richer in stearic acid than palm oil. And Unilever, after analyzing the oil, discovered that the good cholesterol in Allanblackia is more substantial than what you have in palm oil. When you see the Allanblackia oil, I have it here. I think I have my small. Yeah. This is Allanblackia oil. You see this solidity is due to stearic acid. And it's very rare in natural stand. Although people can synthesize it, but up to now, the natural one is very rare. And it is in Allanblackia that you get it. So you see, this is the oil, but it is just like margarine.
Allanblackia represents a huge opportunity because the oil has already been approved for consumption in European Union countries by the European Food Safety Authority. In fact, there are already some brands of margarine containing Allanblackia oil on supermarket shelves in Europe. The big suppliers of oil and seeds are presently Ghana, Nigeria, and Tanzania. However, the bulk of the product comes from the wild. It is only when the fruits have fallen from the tree that you can be sure that they are truly mature and will give a good quality product. Animals love Allanblackia, and often when humans arrive at the foot of the tree, they find that the animals have been there first. This source of supply is therefore insecure.
Je fais une très bonne nourriture et je la consomme. Et puis vous voyez comment ça me ragourdit là. Vous m'avez vu marcher plus vite qu'une puisque je suis à 61 ans de vie. Donc ça me rend jeune quoi. Et puis c'est trop appréciable. C'est un arbre que si on pouvait même le planter, ça nous serait très utile.
At the Mbalmayo station of the World Agroforestry Centre in Cameroon, work is going on to domesticate Allanblackia in line with their mission of detecting and domesticating high-value indigenous fruit trees. 10 years ago, a multinational company contacted the center in Cameroon for help in domesticating Allanblackia.
Before they come to ICRAF Cameroon to contact us, they have erected a big nursery of 600,000 seeds of Allanblackia in Kumasi in Ghana. But after 4, 6, 7 months, no seed germinated. And they were worried because when you talk of 600,000 seed, it is a lot of investment. And if you have to water all those seeds already in the pot for more than 6 months, 7 months, it means a lot of money too.
At the research station, they already have thriving young Allanblackia plants. Some have been propagated from seeds.
We succeeded with our 2-year research to try to reduce the germination phase, which goes, and this germination phase went from 24 months to 3 months now, which is really big achievement.
They have also developed vegetative propagation techniques, that is, from plant material other than seeds. The advantage of these techniques is that the seedlings conserve exactly the same characteristics as the parent plants. Some of the plants are already bearing fruits. Some of the fruits are so heavy on the young branches that they have to be supported to prevent them from breaking.
Some trees are fruiting 4 years after planting, some are doing 5 years after planting. But before this research, they were taking at least 20, 25 years before fruiting. So in short, Allanblackia is a very promising local fruit tree if the decision maker exploit the result we will have definitely. Through this tree, we will encourage farmers to plant other trees as through Allanblackia tree, you can generate income.
These are representatives of different cooperatives, common initiative groups, and farmers' associations. They are here to exchange ideas and knowledge on Allanblackia.
I work with some researchers who came to carry out experiment in the field. They took the fruits, they took the soil samples, and they went back. But in my area, I know that Allanblackia grows along the stream, mostly along the stream, small streams. When I learned that we could domesticate it, I took some fruits, trying to nurse them. It was so difficult. I resorted to germinating, just like what we do in bitter cola. I tied it in a paper with no holes, kept it, they produced roots, then I transferred now into polypots.
C'est mon expérience que j'ai déjà eu à faire. C'est pour ça que j'ai créé déjà un grand champ.
Does Allanblackia do well when under the shade, or is it better to plant the trees under direct sunlight? Those are some of the questions being investigated here in order to give interested farmers good advice. They themselves are also beginning to make useful observations about the optimum conditions for Allanblackia trees to thrive.
Depuis que je travaille avec Allanblackia, j'ai constaté que Allanblackia pousse dans les zones ombrageuses où il n'y a pas assez de soleil, c'est-à-dire sous les arbres, Allanblackia se développe rapidement.
There exist several varieties of Allanblackia with slight variations in aspects like size of fruit and fruit pulp, but all the seeds have Allanblackia oil. The research center is also constituting a gene bank of different varieties. Other African countries are already benefiting from the work being done here.
When I went to Nigeria, there we went to a meeting. After the break time, one of the leaders of that meeting asked us if there are people who want to experience something. We say yes. So we enter the bus, and we arrived there in a big farm. The farm, the Allanblackia farm, was like 15 hectares. So the trees was already bearing fruit. So it was new to me. I started asking the question to the man, and the man said he's here in Cameroon where they came and collect the seeds.
In localities where Allanblackia is already known in Cameroon, it is valued mainly for the bark, which is said to have medicinal properties. People exploit mostly the bark. This tree, for example, is threatened by such over-exploitation. At worst, people think it is a useless tree and simply fell them down to make space for farmland.
I think that government has to join us to tell people that don't cut this tree anymore. It's very important. ICRAF is helping us, but ICRAF can't take such decision to ask people to stop cutting. But now, I'm even using government without their permission. So, I'm even asking God to forgive me because I'm lying. When I reach some area, I will say, don't cut this tree because the paper is already signed. Oh, the person that will cut this tree will go to prison. Oh, but after I will come to that village and train people to tell them that this tree economically can make you feel good tomorrow. Don't get it.
This group of farmers are pioneers. They will make the difference between turning Allanblackia into a cash crop in Cameroon and continuing to allow it to go to complete waste. First, they must know the local names of the tree.
On arrive dans un village donné, on dit je cherche Allanblackia. Franchement, est-ce que quelqu'un va vous répondre?
Jamais.
Ça veut dire que il faut absolument connaître l'appellation locale. N'est-ce pas? Est-ce que nous pouvons faire rapidement un tour pour que chacun nous donne son appellation locale?
Il y a Kene. Mm-hmm. Il y a Ouélé. Mm-hmm. Bon, il y a Issessama. Oui, c'est ça, parce que quand on prend l'écorce,
oui, oui,
ça soigne la toux, mm-hmm, et c'est un peu acide. C'est pour cela qu'on appelle ici ça.
Il y a Bindon, Abing.
On appelle le roc.
Pour collecter en grande quantité, il faut passer par un petit principe qui est très important. Inventorier les arbres que tu dois collecter dans ta zone de travail. C'est très important. Parce que quand tu as déjà collecté les produits dans ta zone, tu as déjà inventorié les arbres, tu peux faire une carte. Tu sais que de tel point à tel point, j'ai 3 arbres. De tel point à tel point, j'ai 2 arbres. De tel point à tel point, j'ai 10 arbres. Ça veut dire qu'on peut déjà prévoir qu'on va utiliser peut-être les collecteurs qui doivent collecter les produits. Si nous voulons atteindre l'objectif, le produit... Peut-être 10 000 litres d'huile au Cameroun par an. Parce que nous avons constaté que 80% de la production reste en forêt. On ne collecte pas. Les animaux mangent, ils sont fatigués. Donc, premier principe, inventorier.
Allanblackia oil is produced from the dried grains extracted from the mature fruits of Allanblackia, One of the main things that the participants of this workshop are here to learn today is to extract Allanblackia oil from the greens. The first thing to do is to ground the greens. Next, the powder obtained is poured into boiling water.
We will wait 10 or 15 minutes before we start removing the oil.
Some of the participants already have some experience with using Allanblackia oil.
L'Allanblackia pour moi c'est surtout l'huile. C'est ça que j'utilise beaucoup pour la fabrication du savon. Je mélange un peu d'huile d'Allanblackia dedans avec l'huile de karité, mon savon du cyprus. Et plus vite. Et le savon sèche aussi très rapidement.
The process is very simple, but painstaking. The product which remains after the oil is skimmed out still contains much oil. Even this byproduct is useful for other purposes.
L'Allanblackia, je l'ai découvert dans un séminaire de l'ICRAF où on m'a dit que ça pouvait conserver le poisson frit pendant un mois. Comme je fais dans la charcuterie, je me suis dit si je prenais ça pour mettre dans mes produits, parce que les produits charcutiers sont assez fragiles. Et si on n'a pas la chaîne de foie assez rapidement, en une journée, on peut perdre toute la production. J'utilise le tourteau. Ça permet au saucisson d'être un peu stable. Et une étudiante a fait des analyses l'année dernière sur le saucisson de poisson et a constaté que le saucisson de poisson peut se conserver 2 jours à température ambiante. C'est-à-dire, on pose ici au soleil pendant 2 jours. Il est consommable. C'est à partir du 3e jour qu'il commence à produire, à développer des micro-organismes. Le saucisson de porc et de poulet peuvent se conserver 1 semaine à température ambiante. Et le bœuf peut se conserver 2 semaines.
To further separate the oil from the solid matter and obtain a purer product, the skimmed oil is brought back to the boil. Twelve kilograms of powder can give about 4 liters of oil. The members of the cooperative that has led this training also make several products ranging from cosmetics like soap, hair and body lotions to health drinks. The products are made from different parts of the Allanblackia fruit and plant, including the fruit pulp, the oil and the bark. There are many claims of the extraordinary virtues of the Allanblackia plant.
Les couteaux la traite, les plaies incurables là, les tumeurs ça traite.
La tisane parvient à calmer les nerfs à partir de ma mère, parce qu'elle a presque 80 ans. Donc quand elle se sent mal à l'aise, je prépare la tisane dans les écorces et les feuilles. Elle boit, ça se calme. Il y a le mal d'estomac. Voilà les deux points, surtout que j'ai déjà bien. Pour l'Allanblackia. Les graines, tu manges les graines, ça calme directement l'estomac.
Je consomme ça depuis environ 5 ans. Vous voyez ma corpulence. Je ne suis pas très gras, je ne suis pas très costaud, je suis sec, solide. Et il y a un docteur qui m'a dit que ça rajeunit. Donc moi je vois que ça rajeunit effectivement.
So what would the scientists make of all of these claims?
We have to remember one thing. We are talking here of local indigenous fruits and surrounded by local indigenous knowledge. all the progress we achieved through domestication, we build it on indigenous knowledge. We tap into indigenous knowledge. So I have the scientific facts on the quality of oil. But the other one, I will never neglect them, because those farmers who knows the species better than the scientists, they also have facts. But with time, what we are going to do is just to transform this local indigenous knowledge into scientific fact and verify it.
This is the powder of Allanblackia grains that have hardened from storage. Producing Allanblackia oil has its challenges.
Les gens en ville refusent d'écraser parce que ça gâte les machines.
Ça nous prend du temps, ça nous prend beaucoup d'argent pour écraser. Si nous on a un moulin qui peut nous écraser ça, on fera ça plus.
Even the local process of oil extraction is time-consuming, and commercializing it is difficult.
Nous continuons à travailler parce que nous-mêmes nous consommons ça. Si on ne regardait que la commercialisation, si on ne fait plus ça.
I will tell them to not be discouraged. You ask me about karité. Karité is worldwide known today, but it took time for karité to reach that level. I'm not afraid that Allanblackia will reach the same level.
Today, these women's cooperative, based in the town of Kribi in Cameroon, are the most advanced in the country as far as the transformation and commercialization of Allanblackia is concerned. They have shown that it is possible to make an income from Allanblackia.
We have 12 points of selling in all Africa now. So we pay salaries. After paying the salaries, the remaining money, we share it with all people that are like our partner in the cooperative. Let me tell you that I would even like women to take this Allanblackia problem as their problem, because this can be also like cocoa, women cocoa in Cameroon. Because when you go to Ghana, you will see that women like us has 50 hectares of this Allanblackia product. So, one woman is able to even produce 1,000 liters per year of oil. If any woman is capable to make 1,000, 2,000, 3,000 liters per year for 5,000, it's enough of money that the woman can take care of her house, of her children, of her household.
Three African countries, Ghana, Tanzania, and Nigeria, are already making use of the opportunity offered by Allanblackia oil. The experiences of the few people who now know about Allanblackia in the country show that there is probably much more to Allanblackia than presently meets the eye. This calls on the scientific community to pay more attention to the plant. In the meantime, Allanblackia represents a great opportunity to diversify revenues and reduce dependence on cocoa and coffee. Those who start planting now will only smile in the future.
The main aim of tree domestication is really to convince farmers, but explain to them through diversification, you can really improve your livelihood, you can have stable income than only concentrating on one species.